Action!
Come on!
Time-wise, it's gone on 4 years, so she's 21 now. She's just coming to the end of her apprenticeship and she's moving out to the village, so she's got her own place and she's finally got her own money. So she's got a bit more independent. She's allowed to, you know, shop around for a boyfriend or, you know. There's a lot of little love birds flying around for a couple of characters, actually, yes. I definitely don't have half the confidence she has. There are some situations where she stands up to people and they're well above her place, and you just think you would never, you'd never be able to get up and shout out the things that she did without expecting some severe consequences, you know. She doesn't give it. I mean, those were the best ones to do, the rioting. I really enjoyed that kind of thing because you just get to do stuff you would never be able to do. It's brilliant because especially down there in the mill yard, you forget where you are completely. There's just not apart from the cameras, obviously, there's nothing modern in sight, and it's really good to get you into it. I think for the first week of the first series we were a bit like, oh god, we got no makeup on, but after a while you're kind of grateful for it because you become so less vain. You stop touching, you know, preening yourself, and because everyone's in it together, it's not just one or two, no one cares anymore. Just get on with it, it's quite nice. I mean, a lot of period stuff obviously is corsets and stuff like that, but no, these are better than my own clothes. There's absolutely nothing holding me in, nothing tight. It's nice, it's nice and cozy actually, yeah. Watch series two because it's quite happy to begin with, and you're kind of like, oh, this is not normal, but there are a lot of dark twists, especially at the end. And so I think you'll be a bit of a guessing game.